after like 5 minutes, we get like a big wall of hammerheads.
So after getting on the boat yesterday, we've now spent the night on the boat, and I just woke up, it's like 6 in the morning, I was sleeping over here with Max and Cassie, and as you see, it's pretty nice. I'm just gonna do some dive briefing and then jump in the water, and looking forward to go diving.
Summer fog, everyone!
Before each dive, we're going to have a dive site briefing. So I'm sure you've all seen dive site briefings before. Mr. Farage has drawn a beautiful map of the dive site so we can see kind of what the reef looks like and what we expect on the water.
Explain what just happened.
Me and Hugo went a little bit earlier than the rest of the group to explore a little bit more and about Nil Desperandum, which is very famous for hammerhead sharks.
And it's in the middle of nowhere.
Basically. Yeah, especially the middle of nowhere. It's the closest place to like connection is probably more than 1 day. So we dropped down after like 5 minutes, we get like a big wall of hammerheads. Maybe between like 30 to 50 hammerheads.
That's so it's just crazy. Insane. First time ever I've seen hammerheads. It's quite rare to see them.
Yeah. Super rare sharks. One of the rarest sharks in the world. Only see just a few places in Indonesia where you can see them. This is one of them. So we're really lucky to see them. Yeah, the hammerhead sharks doesn't really like warm water and sun. So when it's like raining like we do today, it's still dark. And it's a little bit more, it's 30 degrees on the surface. When you drop down a little bit deeper, around 30. So getting like 26 degrees, that's the spot where the hammerheads like to hang out. And when it gets a little bit current, so the sharks are just hovering, they get like protruding water inside the gills, breathing. It's a perfect spot to find them.